Hello, my name is Amandine Scherer. I am part of the community team, and I am here with Jeff Wissmans from the Open University, director of CSIC, who is going to comment about the day. So what did you think about the day, Jeff?
I thought it was a very exciting day. Lots happened, many papers and so on. So it's always a bit difficult to comment more generally on a day like this, since so many ideas are still buzzing around, in my head at least. But maybe I can talk from my own interest, which is very much about the constitution of the international, what's international order. And what was particularly interesting, I found, was that when you look at what Inge Neisen called the undoing of citizenship that started off the day today, that things start shifting about. One can't talk that easily about international relations as just a politics between states or even a politics of colonization or decolonization. Questions are raised around citizenship, which is clearly a concept as the last keynote lecture, as the keynote lecture specifically made. It's invested in its own history of colonizing, westernizing, and so forth. But then, if you actually start exploring it as opening up kinds of questions of how people practice, appropriate, which is a term that wasn't used very often, but which I find always very interesting, is how terminologies which have a clear history, political history, are part of a politics, become appropriated, reinvested, recaptured in other places, in other times, in other projects, how they open up various questions. And I thought lots of that happened today, which of course culminated in the keynote lecture by Walter Mignolo, where the whole questions about westernization, what does de-westernization mean, and then became hooked into, very interestingly for me, in a completely different view on the rise of China, not anymore as the rising great power, but as the rising great power indeed, but ultimately also the rising of a question about what de-westernization means, what does it mean, as he concluded, he said, when you invest Confucianism in the constitution or in the conception of the state, and what have they to say about human rights, and suddenly the questions of human rights, citizenship, humanity open up in various ways. And I think it shifts about how you look at international relations. The other thing I liked very much is also that it becomes not an international relations bottom-up, because the terminologies are institutional to some extent as well, but there is kind of practice which are often not seen, whether it's the practice of the settler in relation to the indigenous people, whether it's practices of certain social movements that were talked about, like the Indignato and so on. So I think it shifts about what we see that politics is, and it's a politics of the international very much today, or a politics of the global or of the world. And I think that was very interesting for me. So I would think if, for example, I would run with these, not with the terminology, the institutional terminology of citizenship, humanity, democracy, but the way they are actually enacted and also used as acts and appropriation to actually build critique, but then themselves also become critiqued from other angles, I think we get a different view of politics, and the politicality of these terms becomes very central again. And therefore the question of political subjectivity opens up. And I think that's really interesting in today, and I'm sure that will, it's in the nature of the project to come in to do that, and I think it will actually carry through tomorrow.